Empty streets have become the new normal during the COVID-19 pandemic. Thousands laid off or furloughed, stores shut down, public gatherings banned, travel restrictions and physical distancing imposed, as a third of the world practices some form of a lockdown to slow down the spread of COVID-19. And all of this is having an impact on our global economy. Industries like airlines, import-export companies, tourism, retailers, events, restaurants, and many other non-essential services have been hit, some harder than others. The United Nations says we may see a $2 trillion shortfall in our global income and a $220 billion hit to developing countries, excluding China, because of COVID-19.
It's catastrophic. We've never seen anything like this. We have a huge portion of the economy and people under lockdown, and that's going to have a huge impact on what can be produced and not produced.
Many services have been able to go digital in an effort to continue running their business, such as e-learning, online fitness classes, food and grocery delivery services, and telecommunication apps.
We're seeing this massive push that's going to result in all kinds of services being available remotely that previously weren't.
And many companies have been able to adapt to working from home, a new pattern that seems to be forming as a part of our new reality.
I think this is certainly going to be one of the long-term legacies of this crisis, is that people will work differently and will interact differently. The crisis is going to motivate capability development and the energy and imperative to move to digital.
But there are many industries that can't switch to a digital platform and continue functioning, such as hair salons, spas, events, movie theaters, and the tourism industry.
80% of the Canadian economy is services. And most of those services require some kind of a personal touch, not all, you know, kind of necessarily high touch, but those businesses are really just kind of getting slammed. So if they can't pivot to digital online fulfillment and purchase, then they're basically shut down. So if you're in that worst case scenario of can't transform my business model into digital, and if you're a, you know, non-staple type of purchase, and you have low financial resilience, access to cash and credit, that's where we're going to see carnage first.
But a particular industry that is experiencing both the positive and negative effects from COVID-19 is the oil industry. While the steep decline in gas prices isn't good for countries which rely on oil exports, it's a good thing for consumers and can be a benefit to the global economy.
An oil price decline of this magnitude is typically a significant benefit for the global economy in a sort of synchronized downturn, because yes, oil exporting countries have a lot less revenue, but they constitute a much smaller share of global consumers than the oil importing countries do. And when you want a global recovery to begin or strengthen, you really have to have the largest number of people face a declining price of an item that they always buy, namely oil. So overall, this is a benefit, in my opinion, in the short run for the global economy.
It's only been a few weeks since parts of the world have essentially come to a halt. So figuring out how long this economic decline will last is a challenge.
Very difficult to call anything that requires us to know things that we still don't know. I mean, even the experts, epidemiologists and virologists, are still trying to figure this out.
Health experts have said it could be months before we start seeing signs of change, and social distancing could continue for quite some time depending on how much the virus continues to spread. So in the meantime, there will continue to be a great deal of pressure placed on governments.
It will be the role of the government, frankly, to ensure income security for people, and to the extent possible, also provide the kind of mitigating factors that allows companies to survive, even if they have no business. That, for instance, would mean subsidizing the wages of workers, facilitating that they can roll over loans, offering state-guaranteed cheap loans and things like that.
What we know at this point, based on experts, is that social and physical distancing, as well as washing your hands, helps slow down the spread of the novel coronavirus. And the sooner it comes to a halt, the faster the economy can begin recovering.
Thanks for watching Global News. If you want to stay up to date on the latest breaking national and international news, be sure to subscribe to our channel.